In today's video, we're going to use Play on Mac. So that's basically a OS X application that makes installing wine and using different wine versions or wine bottles very simple. We're just going to download version 4.2.2 here. The web address will be in the description down below. So we just start the download. I'm just going to go through the process on screen here for you now. It's quite a simple process, and yeah, if you follow along with the instructions on screen or down below, you should get it installed fairly quickly. There's a few steps to go through, but each step is very simple. As you can see now, we've downloaded it. We just drag it to our applications folder. The first time you launch it, of course, you're going to get a pop-up box saying this application was downloaded from the internet. And also, if you haven't changed your security permissions, you might not be able to run it. So just a heads up there. What I've done is right click and kept it in the dock so we can run it easily from the dock. This is just asking us if we want to send usage information back to the Play on Mac servers. But I don't usually send usage information for anything I run, so I just didn't allow that. And that's just a firewall pop-up you're seeing there. All right, so this is the first run wizard. So the first time you use it, you'll just go through these steps. This only happens on the first time and after you've got XQuartz installed and restarted. So we're just going to start the install process of XQuartz now. It'll just take a little bit as we have to download and then install it. So we just follow the on-screen instructions, and it's a straightforward process. The Play on Mac actual application makes everything very simple and easy to use. That's why I recommend using this. There are other options for Mac, but this is by far the easiest, so just go with that. Why make things more complicated than you need to? And as you can see, there's a little lock icon there. That means that the developer has a certificate, so you can trust that developer, allegedly. So we're just running a few package scripts now, and then once that's installed, we'll be able to restart or log off and log on to restart the X server. So yeah, it says you need to log off and log on, but we just restart in any case. So we click OK there and then continue. And as you can see here, X11 bin is opened. Just allow that through the firewall. I'm just going to click I agree here and click next to reboot the computer. And then I'll resume the recording from when I've rebooted. Okay, we've rebooted now. And there's a few more things we've got to configure, which is just the fonts. So we've got to download and install the fonts. As you can see here, little snitches popping up with quite a lot of things. So what I end up doing is allowing it for 15 minutes while I get the fonts installed, and then we can take it from there. Okay, so I just click next here, and I agree to the license terms, obviously. All right, and now we're ready to start using Play on Mac. So as you can see there, there's the configure button. Once you've got a wine version set up and applications, you can do more configuration from here. If you have a look, we've got some plugins, a plugin manager, and tools, and manage wine version. So the first thing you need to do is install a wine version. And the version we're going to go for is 1.6.2, but some applications require a specific version of wine, as you can see here. So we're just going to get it, move up to 1.6.2. You can install a later version, but some of them are a bit buggy, so I tend to use the stable version just for simplicity's sake. And it's just a matter of following the on-screen instructions. We'll download wine, get that installed. Okay, now we've got that installed, we're going to download MetaTrader 5. And as you can see in the downloads down the bottom, it has a little Play on Mac icon. So I'll just quit Safari, and there you can see MT5 setup with the Play on Mac icon. So I'm just running that now. So it's Play on Mac is analyzing your application. And then it's just follow the on-screen prompt. So we click next and we type in the name for our application. And then next. And then from here on, the installation is very similar to the Windows installation. Well, it's exactly the same as the Windows installation, except for a couple of post-installation things. So you can see there, Wine's getting the configuration ready because it's the first time we've ran Wine. So we're just, here we go. Now I'm going to allow Wine through the firewall for an hour, I think, just to get everything installed properly. So I allow that. And then as you can see, it's just a matter of installing MetaTrader as you would normally. So we go through that process and you'll see that it looks like Play on Mac has failed. You see the sad face and it says your installation might not have succeeded, but there's nothing wrong with it. Okay, and we just go through a demo account and as you can see, everything's working pretty well. And I'm opening the meta editor here and not an issue there. So here you can see just opening and looking at where the files are located in Wine Explorer. But in a later video, I'll go through that in more detail. So we'll just close this out now. We'll go through making shortcuts and putting them on the desktop and putting them in the toolbar so it's easy for you to access your applications. So what we do now is we just click next. We're just going to ignore that message. It's not an issue at all. And this is the basic automatic installation part of it to make a shortcut. So we're just going to make a shortcut for terminal. And we're also going to make a shortcut for the meta editor as well. And as you can see, we've got those shortcuts on our desktop now. Okay, and we can just drag them down to our dock just so we can launch them from there. These are basically, as you can see now, this will just launch the XQuartz application to run Wine. So it's just think of those as a shortcut to the launcher, which is just an X11 application, as you can see here. All right, thanks for watching. And as always, like this video, give me some comments below. Let me know what you think. And don't forget to subscribe. Okay, thanks for watching, guys.